हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन डिजिटल वर्जन 2.0 एंड आई एम डॉक्टर लिली त्रिवेदी एंड टुडे द टॉपिक इज बायोलॉजिकल नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन विच सिम्बियोटिक एसोसिएटिव एंड ए सिम्बियोटिक। नाउ दिस लेक्चर इज फॉर PSC honors agriculture second sem and the course is agriculture microbiology. What is biological nitrogen fixation? The synthesis of organic nitrogenous compounds from atmospheric nitrogen by certain microorganisms is called biological nitrogen fixation. Since the higher plants cannot directly utilize this molecular nitrogen of the atmosphere, certain microorganisms which can utilize this atmospheric nitrogen are there to help. So there are two types of nitrogen fixing organism, asymbiotic and symbiotic. Now asymbiotic are the free living nitrogen fixing organisms, and they are the following organisms which can fix atmospheric nitrogen: the aerobic bacteria and anaerobic bacteria. They are saprophytic organisms. They can fix nitrogen only in the soil. The soil must have a good supply of organic manure. And the example of anaerobic is Clostridium, and example of aerobic is Azotobacter. We have then next is blue-green algae, that is cyanobacteria. So they are autotrophic photosynthetic organisms. They grow in waterlogged and wet soil like rice paddy fields. They are member of Nostocales and Stignonemates. Some of the examples are Anabina. It is an important member. It has branched filaments, and these filaments have two types of cells: the green photosynthetic cells, which fix atmospheric carbon dioxide and release oxygen during photosynthesis. And second is heterocyst cell. They are slightly enlarged colorless cells. They are non-photosynthetic and they fix atmospheric nitrogen. Some of the blue-green algae do not have heterocyst, but they can also fix nitrogen. Then blue-green algae in higher living plants. The blue-green usually are free living, but when they enter the tissue of the higher plants, they stay inside, like Nostoc in the mucilaginous cavity of Anthoceros, which is a bryophyte. Some Anabina live in leaf cavities of ferns. They have the nitrogen fixing ability to fix nitrogen for the higher plants. Now the nitrogenous substance directly passes from algae to higher plants, and the carbohydrate from the plant to the cyanobacteria algae. So it is a symbiotic association. Now lichens, Nostoc and Schistonema develop symbiotic association with fungi, and this is called lichens. The algal component fixes the atmospheric nitrogen in the form of organic compound. Now, biological nitrogen fixation, for this symbiotic nitrogen fixation, is very important. It is the most important of biology. Now, here we see this is diagram showing stages of nodule formation. The root here, where the rhizobia comes and attaches itself, and it forms nodules on the root. Certain fungi like Actinomyces also develop mycorrhizal association with roots of Pinus, Casuarina, etc. Now they are ectotrophic or endotrophic, and these fungi also fix atmospheric nitrogen. But the most important is the nodule forming rhizobium species. It is the most important for nitrogen fixation. A large number of leguminous plants like bean, peas, soybean, they develop root nodules. In fact, all these papilionaceae members develop root nodules. Now, these root leguminous plants increase soil fertility. Bejernick, a German bacteriologist, identified that rhizobium infects the root system and they develop nodules. The bacteria mainly develop atmospheric nitrogen in the form of amino acids. These amino acids are transported by transpiration stream to different parts of the plants. And the bacteria in turn gets carbohydrate from legumes. So this is again a symbiosis, and the nodules are not formed if the bacteria rhizobium is not present. Now, nodules are formed by the following process. There is an infection thread formation. The nodules which are causing bacteria are present in the soil. Now, roots excrete some sugar and amino acids which attract these bacteria, and the bacteria start multiplying near the root zone. Now, they develop sufficient population and infect the root here. A number of changes take place in the root here, and the nucleus of the root here becomes double in size. The cell wall loses and the plasma nerve invaginates and engulfs the bacterium. So the root here in turn becomes curled and the bacterium becomes thread-like inside the root here. This is called the infection thread. The next stage is formation of root nodule. Now the infection threads become branched, and these branches grow from one cell to next cell, and they extend up to 44 cells of the root. Now these cells start dividing, and the growth substances like auxin, cytokinin, they are secreted by bacteria to stimulate cell division. And thus finally a tumor-like structure appears, and this is called nodule. Bacteroids formation. As the nodules grow and increase in size, the vascular tissues extend to the tip of the nodule. So the bacteria multiplies rapidly in the host of the root nodule, and the infection threads now change into globular oval cells, and these cells are called bacterioids. And the nitrogen fixation is carried by these bacterioids. Fourth is leg hemoglobin formation. Now the nodule is pink in color. Why it is pink in color? Due to presence of pigment leg hemoglobin. Now this is the pigment which the host cells of the plant are forming due to response due to bacterial infection. Now this is very similar to hemoglobin of mammals, and it is present in leguminous plants, so therefore it is called leg hemoglobin. What is the significance of this? This is very important pigment, and the ability of nitrogen fixation depends on this pigment. As the older nodules lose this pigment, they lose the color and become green or brown, and they fail to fix the nitrogen. This leg hemoglobin is an oxygen carrier, and thus oxygen becomes available for rapid respiration, and ATP is synthesized inside the nodule. So nitrogen fixation is a reductive process. It requires large amount of energy, and by respiration, this energy supplied, and leg hemoglobin supplies oxygen for respiration. So this is the process which is responsible. Now here is an overview of nitrogen fixation, how from the atmosphere nitrogen fixing soil bacteria and blue-green algae fix nitrogen in the plant, and how ammonia is released, and further on the nitrogen fixation cycle. Now some nitrogen fixing organisms, these are the examples, and azospirillum is a free-living associative bacteria. Symbionts are rhizobium and franchia. Free living are Clostridium, purple sulfur bacteria, green sulfur bacteria, purple non-sulfur bacteria, B. sulfovibrio. And free living aerobic bacteria are Azotobacter, Cyanobacter, Bejernick, and Klebsiella. So here again is a diagrammatic of how the root is formed. So you can see here, this is the root here, and the rhizobia is attaching to the root here. Then the infection thread is formed through which the bacteria enters the root cells. Now here the bacteria changes into bacteroids and their packed root cells enlarge. And this is the enlarged root cell which is forming a nodule. So this is a very clear diagram. And the infection process, again to sum up, first is attachment, second is root hair curling, third is localized cell wall degradation, fourth is the infection thread formation, fifth is the cortical cell differentiation. Then the rhizobia is released into the cytoplasm and the bacteroid differentiation takes place, and finally induction of noduline. So children, students, I hope you have liked my lecture. These are the references which I have used for the preparation, and I hope you have enjoyed my lecture. And if you have any query, any question, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. This session was powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University. Thank you very much. Namaste.